by Missionary Ruthling Hendricks.
With bow head. Father God, we want to thank you on this afternoon.
Yes.
For just blessing us to be able to assemble together one more time. We have come into your house to worship you, to give your name the glory and the honor and the praise all day. Father God, you have been most merciful to us, and we said thank you.
Thank you.
We said thank you.
Thank you.
You blessed us in our going out and our coming in. And we said thank you, sir. Father God, you've been good to us, better to us than we are even to ourselves. And we stop by just to tell you thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, we ask that you bless this tea on today. Father, each one that's assembled, let your spirit dwell in this place. Father God, we ask that you anoint the speaker for today, God. Give her a word for this hour, Father God. Help us to open up our hearts to be receptive to the words that you have for us. In the name of Jesus. Now, Father, we ask that you bless our leaders, God. Bless our bishop and his wife. Bless our supervisor, God. In the name of Jesus. Our pastors, God, as they lead your people. And help us as lay people to follow your word, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. We give you the glory. We give you the praise. And we say thank you, God. Amen.
Not today, not
But we thank God, amen. Now we can just kind of loosen up. Are you all glad to be here?
Amen.
Our guest is coming in, amen. Let's say amen for Missionary Vera Lewis. So good to see you. Amen. This is the annual silver tea. Amen. And we're glad to be here. Glad to see each and every one of you here on this afternoon. At this time, we're going to have the welcome address by Missionary Lakati Hadley. Is she here? Amen. If not, Missionary B. Would you mind coming and doing the welcome on this afternoon? Thank you. It's Sister Monica Moore here. Thank you,
and to God be the glory,
amen,
for the things that He has done. And it is marvelous in our eyes. At this time, I just want to take the time to welcome you to the 5th Annual Silver Tea. Hope that you enjoy yourself, enjoy the food, enjoy the company, and you are welcome. Welcome.
Is Sister Monica Moore here? If not, can we get someone to respond to the welcome? We are glad to be here, and thank you for welcoming us here. We're glad to be here. We're going to have a wonderful time on this afternoon. At this time, we want to acknowledge our First Lady of our jurisdiction.
Amen.
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 Let's say amen for her. Amen. We love you, Missionary Houston. And we want you to know we are praying for you and we think of you often. Amen. At this time, we will have a sign language presentation. I'm not sure if she's here. She's from a little princess. She's not here yet. Okay. Mother's calling for Jada. Is she here? All right. We thank God for her. Would you give her a hand as she comes?
I'm thankful to be here from Houston. I take a sign language course at University of Houston for interpreting, and my passion is doing sign language to music first, and second, interpreting for people that are there. So I pray that you all are blessed by this song.
Oh,
I want to apologize to you. I got in a rush and forgot my manners. So let me just start right now and acknowledge the head table. We thank God for the Bishop of the Texas Northeast Jurisdiction number 2, our very own Bishop David R. Houston. And his lovely wife, Missionary Lillian Houston.
Amen.
Our guest speaker on this evening, Missionary Vera Lewis. We thank God for you. And then the Supervisor of Texas Northeast number 2, our own mother, Mother Artie, Morrow. And then she's working right now, Missionary Yvonne Atkins. We thank God for her. And then the second vice president, I believe, of the International Sunday School Department, District Superintendent Rodney Lamar Atkins. We thank God for all of you on this evening. Now, at this time, we're going to have a roll call of the district missionaries by Missionary Dorothy Langley. Is she here? Okay, if not, the district missionaries are on the back. I'm not sure how she would have done this, but we want to recognize our district missionaries at this time. So I'm going to call you by your name. You can raise your hand. District Missionary Jacqueline Allen. Amen. District Missionary Stephanie Beasley. Gave us their warm welcome. District Missionary Mary R. Berry.
Amen.
District Missionary Christy Copeland. District Missionary Tammy Edwards. District Missionary Linda Evans. Amen. District Missionary Myra Hart.
In the kitchen.
There she is. She's working too. All right. District Missionary Darlene Howard. Amen. Thank God for you. District Missionary Corey Kelly. Amen. District Missionary Bobby Lee. Okay. District Missionary Joyce McAllister. Amen. District Missionary Bertha Nelson.
Here.
All right. She's working too. District Missionary Letty Payne. Amen. Thank God for you. District Missionary Vivian Peoples. All right. District Missionary Patsy Tutt. She's okay. Designate District Missionary Tina Washington. Amen. District Missionary Sandra Williams. All right. Thank you. Thank you. Let's give all of our district missionaries. All right. At this time, we're going to have the blessing of the food. Superintendent Jesse Nelson here. If not, I'm going to ask if Superintendent Atkins would come and bless the food.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless this food that we're about to receive for the nourishment of our bodies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
A portion of this little song I was singing in the car. Amen.
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 And we thank you, Missionary Veronica Smith, for that. Amen. Sister Jada is coming. She's getting prepared to come. Amen. We just thank God for who he is. Amen. Aren't you glad that you're saved on today?
Amen.
Amen. There is nothing like being saved and sanctified and filled with the precious Holy Ghost. And we give God praise just for who he is. Amen. That we could have been dead, could have been cut off or anything. But God thought enough of us. Amen. To shower us with his blessings. Spare our lives and let us live to see another day. And we give God praise for that. Amen. Sister Jada is coming.
Thank you.
Secretary Deborah Walton. Where are you? Your mom is calling. Amen. Your mom is calling. Amen. Didn't we enjoy that?
Amen.
The precious Lamb of God. Amen. One of these days, and it won't be very long, we're going to all sing and give glory to the Lamb of God. Aren't you looking forward to that day?
Amen.
Amen. Missionary Walton.
Yeah. We're so happy to have everybody here today, and we're just so glad to be able to feed all of you.
We're so glad you
are. Thank you, Sister Atkins. We're going to start lining up from both sides of the wall. These tables.
Her mission is to give hope, encouragement, and inspiration to every soul she encounters to survive against all odds and in spite of what has happened to them. She was saved at the early age of 14 years old, and God has continued to anoint and use her. She is the co-founder of the Bethlehem Church of God in Christ, located in Fort Worth, Texas, which was founded by her visionary husband, the late Elder James David Lewis. Evangelist Lewis is a retired nurse and mother of three children. She has dedicated her life to the care of others, both naturally and spiritually. She is the proud grandmother of the grandsons who have already begun to carry out the Lewis tradition of excellence. She is founder and president of the Bionic Women of God, which is an active women's organization that provides Christmas toys, school supplies, and clothes to needy, underprivileged children, Thanksgiving dinners to families in need, and scholarships to deserving students. The Bionic Women of God are a strong group of women making a difference in today's society. At this time, we're going to ask our own mother, Artie Morrow, to come. She is going to present our speaker, after which he will be in the hands of Missionary Walton.
Thank you, Missionary Jules. First, I give honor to God today. And I praise the Lord today for blessing us to be together one more time. I do give honor to the bishop of this jurisdiction, Bishop David R. Houston, and also Mother Houston, a lady of renown. A lady who has worked, and as I began to see you line up, my mind went back to her. She is a woman, I have not kept up with the number, but I'm sure they have read me for how many people. That she has stood for how many years? 16 years, and fed masses of people through the bread of the sovereign land. This was just a potion, and I happened to come over to assist her, but it looked like it was going to be a conflict of interest, because she was telling me I couldn't come, and I'm saying, I can. So we don't want this old lady to be pushing on this young lady, and they didn't want to see that young lady pushing this old lady, so I decided I would just stay at home. But she's fed so many people. And today we are happy to have her here.
Amen.
And we are glad to know that we have a leader of this magnitude. We also appreciate all of you who have taken our time to come. And to all of the district missionaries and your guests, we certainly do appreciate your effort that you have put forth to make this a great occasion. And you can see on your program that we have been working entirely to do a work for the Lord. And it takes finance and someone to do the work. So we're working on a building today. We we're trying to reach the unreached, and we're trying to seek the unsolved. And we are happy today to know that you did take time. You couldn't, then some could not come today. We got death messages and couldn't make it, but we know to pray for those people. Now, I want to let you know that I'm almost lost for words that are inadequate to thank you all for your coming today. I should like to make mention, I do have, you are my family, I have a biological family who is sitting to my extreme right. And they are Relafay, I can't see Quentin, but look back, that's Quentin. My son-in-law, who is from Houston, Texas, and where is my son and my pastor? Oh, there you are. Everybody knows Pippa, so wave your hand. There you are. But we are glad that they are here to embrace our work. And let's, we have time of a Sister Jada. She is my granddaughter from Houston, Texas. And I'm going to tell you just a little bit about, she was about this tall. I had taken sick and looked to me like the five girls were just walking around like bumblebees wondering what to do. And she said, is grandmother sick? They said, yeah. She says, get back. And they want to know, what are you telling us? You to look for this. So she said, where is the oil? And then she crawled up in the bed and got the oil off the shelf and came and anointed grandmother's head. And the Lord healed me. And I thank the Lord that she is yet following into the footsteps of Jesus Christ and doing a ministry for the Lord. And also, I'm not going to ask our First Lady to exalt herself any further. You know what she does. We don't have to make no big nothing about her. Her work stands for her in the game. She is that woman that the Bible speaks of. She does take care of all of us. We are her children. And she knows us all just about by name. Do not upset her. Do the right thing. And all she wants us to do is to be lovely and sweet. And that's what we're going to do. Now, I'm going to relinquish myself. I've met the speaker for a long time. I knew her husband from Lubbock, Texas, I believe. They're a great usher in this church. There's a great history behind this woman. So I asked the Lord to give us a speaker for today. And he gave us this lady. And we pray that you will really enjoy if you don't nourish it. And maybe someday you will enjoy it. I am going to present another person. And shall we not forget the Dr. Atkins, who is at my left side, and his lovely wife. And I can't just go on and on, but we appreciate all of you. And Sister Jett is there. Raise your hand, Sister Jett. She's here with us today. Even if she had to come in a wheelchair, if she had to come on a walker, she's here today. And let's give God a big at this time, we do have a special guest with us today. A person with whom I have been acquainted with for a little while. And I saw this child, and I saw the potential in this child, and I asked the mother, if we had anything in the jurisdictional, in the national, I wanted to see her go forward. And she is here today. And Sister Deborah Pippa is coming to present her to us. And after she shall have finished, we will receive our guest speaker for today.
Thank you, Mother Morrow. I'm glad to be here on today, and we give honor to all of our leaders and our guests, and to everyone that's here on today. We have a young lady, I wanted to say real angel, but we know that an angel is a male factor. So I just gave her another name because I didn't know her name. And her name is Jada Blaylock. And she is 6 years old. She's from Douglasville, Texas. Her mother is Lorticia Hare, and her aunt is Catherine Gibson. So at this time, we're gonna ask her to come and do our sign language rendition. A rendition for us all today. We saw her at Elder Byron Haskins Church in Pittsburgh District, and we just wanted to have her in our presence at our next event that we had. And said we are glad to have her in the house of the Lord, and she is great in what she does. And will you please give her a hand at this time?
Thank you. Know that he will do the unusual. He will
will make a way out of no way. He is what you need, he's what you have. And don't let the enemy talk to you and bring you down to think that this is going to be the rest of your life. That you're going to be down and out and broken discouraged. You have to believe that God is about to do a new thing in your life. And when he brings about the change in your life, you have to know that God is doing this thing and give him the glory. But I found out even when we're going through, you have to praise him before it happens.
Yes.
You have to praise him so it looks like you've lost your mind. You have to praise him under pressure until you get heaven's attention. Until heaven says, who is this praising me under pressure? Who is this praising me when they should be crying? Who is this praising me when they don't even know how they're going to pay their rent tomorrow? Because we have come where we know how to pretend. We have a facade where we know how to look good on the outside. But about to go under on the inside. Sometimes coming to church and even in this environment here, you're sitting here next to someone and you're about to go under for the last count. Sometimes you have to know that you know that you know that you know,
yes,
that God has a way out.
Yes.
How many know God has a way out of no way?
Yes.
Can bring about the impossible in your life. But it is about time for a miracle.
Yes.
God is saying the drought in your life is about to end.
Right.
In spite of where you are now and what's going on, you have to believe that this is your year.
All right.
You have to know, in spite of, that you are a miracle yourself.
Right.
In spite of how you're feeling, some people say, I've never seen a miracle. Then you turn around and tell your neighbor, just look at me.
Yes.
If you want to see a miracle, then look at me. If you want to touch a miracle, you can even touch me right now.
Yes.
Knowing that if it had not been for God on your side, you wouldn't even be here today.
Right.
Don't let the enemy talk you out of your miracle.
All right.
Don't let him tell you that your life will going to be down and out all the time.
Right.
You have to know that you're a survivor. And God is about to do the new thing in your life.
Yes.
You have to know that in spite of what you're going through is on purpose.
Yeah, that's right.
God is trying to give you a testimony to tell others that I yet live.
Yes.
And I yet bring to pass that which you thought would never happen.
Right.
Knowing that whatever you're going through, you're not going under, but you shall survive.
Right.
Come on, say, I shall survive.
Time to
speak, a time to love, and a time to to hate.
Yes.
A time of war and a time of peace. But I thought it's a time for going through, but then it's a time for coming out.
Yes.
There's a time of struggle, but then there's a time for prosperity.
Yes.
There's a time of bondage, but there's a time of breakthrough.
Yes.
There's a time of depression, but there's a time of gladness.
Yes.
A time for the ordinary, and then it's about time for a miracle. Events in the Bible, but sometimes you need to Richmond, Reverend Lewis always had mission. They made a $325 a piece. I said, well, just change my oil. For some reason, the oil at the Cadillac house costs more than the oil at the other place. I don't know if it's made out of gold or what. But I said, well, give me the oil, and then six, give me a turn, and I'm going to come back at the, for the other turn. I sat in the office, and I started talking to the young lady about the goodness of God.
Yeah.
business for her womb to be closed. But God was going to do a miracle. Yes, he was. In your life. Seems like nothing significant is happening. Seems like it's stagnant. Seems like you're going through so much. To be in 2 feet or one. You feel like you could drown.
Yeah.
Uh-uh, couldn't
Yeah. indeed an honor to introduce our leader. He's been leading us for 25 years. We just celebrated our 25th year. I present to you Bishop David Artie. Remember the Haynes family in Nebraska. And the Jewish people.